I talked to you the other day about my Chuck Chula, my new crafting project, and I said that I was going to go live and do a demo craft with you, so I'm going to do that right now and show you exactly how fun and easy this is. I picked from my stencils, and I thought this one would just be a fun one to do. This is how they come on a sheet. So you basically will have to cut them out and separate them if there's multiple transfers on one sheet. So I'm gonna go ahead and start to cut this out. Good morning, hi friends. And my comments are working today. I couldn't see your comments the other day when I went live, so I couldn't even, I didn't know who was on or what people were saying. So I can see you today, so thank you, say hello. And also, if you want to win a little free sample package of Chocolatour, like a transfer and a little paste and a little board, go ahead and like my page. I'm doing this on my regular page, but I have Frida's Design, so go ahead and like that and share it. And we'll go ahead and, if you tag a friend, whoever does the most, I can send you out a little giveaway freebie for you to try at home. So I'm going to go ahead and get started. I'm going to turn the camera down so that you can see what I'm doing, and hopefully this works because this is my first time doing this. Okay, so here's the transfer we're going to use today, and I'm going to also use this part of it. And then I have the board that I'm going to put it on, the chalkboard. And so first, let's go ahead and get you situated and angle you down. Let's see how this is. Move this over here, get this centered. Okay, I think, can you see okay? Is it okay? Say yes, somebody tell me. I don't know if I can see your comments or not. Somebody say hi in the comments so I can see if it pops up. And then I'm just gonna start cutting this out while you guys watch and see if I can get a comment. So here's this one, and then I'm going to go ahead and cut this one. Now, transfers are different than stencils. This is almost like silk screen. You're going to see how really thin it all is. So what we'll do is go ahead and peel this off the paper, which can be fun to get started sometimes. Let's see if I can get this. Try a different corner. Now, I've seen that when you peel these, you want to not rip it from the corner across. You want to kind of go up or down, but not across, because you don't want to stretch it, because like I said, this is pretty thin. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and lay this on the chalkboard where I want it. And you want to make sure, oh, I forgot to do something, hold on 1 second. When you first use these, I forgot, you want to take it and put it on a towel, like a piece of fabric or something, just to kind of help with the stickies, because then when you peel it off the chalkboard, if you're gonna use it on a flat surface or a smooth surface, it kind of makes it harder to peel off. So for the first time, I'm just gonna put it on the towel to kind of just help it so it's not so sticky when I go to peel it off. Okay, so I'm gonna do this, and now I'll go ahead and put it back on the board. Try to center it the best I can. All right, so we have that, and then this one, I think I'm just gonna wait until I peel this top one off, and then I'll do the bottom one, just because it's gonna overlap a little. I guess I could do both. Yeah, I think I can make it work with both. So let's go ahead and do this one as well. This is Design, Love, Repeat, so that'll be fun. And I'm gonna do the same thing, just apply it. If you don't have a towel around, it doesn't matter. You could do it to your shirt or your pants, whatever you have. just try to get some of that sticky. These are hard to get off here the first time. Are you guys having a good Sunday morning? It's kind of here in Dallas. Looks like it's going to rain, so I'm totally fine with sitting here crafting. And right now, Jackson is outside with Frank doing some work out in the workshop. Frank built me a ton of chalkboard frames last night, so I'm so excited I can do so many more crafts. I really wish I would have got involved in this before, not so close to Easter, because they have the cutest little... I did it again. Did you see it? Why didn't you guys tell me? It looks like it's going to come off okay, so I guess I won't worry too much about it. We'll see. We'll see how it does. I was supposed to put it on the tile to get the fuzzies off, but I forgot again. Maybe I should drink some more of this, right? Do you guys have your coffee, water, orange juice? Let's go. Mimosas? I'm going to turn this into a drinking event. Like, we can craft and drink together. Cheers. Do I need to join broadcast to hear you better? Okay, let me see if my volume's down. Hold on a second. If I can turn it up. I don't know why my volume isn't that great. Okay, I turned it up, so hopefully this is better and I'll talk a little louder, okay? All right. So, next I'm going to get out my paint. I'm going to just do white today. I have several colors, but I like the way the white looks on the black chalkboard. And I also have the squeegee. So the squeegee is what makes it go over the transfer nice and smooth and spread it. Let's see if I can get this open. Where's my opening? Okay, there it is. And these squeegees come in different sizes. So you can use, there's the thicker side. And then there's the thinner side. So the thinner side is where we're going to kind of just spread across the board. Okay? I hope you guys can see okay. And I'll try to talk louder. I don't know why it's so hard for you guys to hear me, but we'll talk louder. Okay, so next I'm going to get out my chalk paint. And the consistency of this is supposed to be like yogurt. So you can do two things. If it's not really like that, you can stir it with a stick. I just have a wood stick here. And if you're stirring it and it's a little dried out, it doesn't have that yogurt consistency, then you're going to want to maybe just spritz it with a little water. You can get a little water bottle, do a spritz or two, and then you can mix it up and then it'll get it to the right consistency. Okay, so what we're going to do is... I'm just going to use this to get the chalk out. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and just put a little on here. And as you can see, you don't really need a lot. A little goes a long way. If you need more, you can grab more. If you put too much on, you can wipe it off, so it's not a big problem. Okay, so I'm just going to go ahead and just start spreading. So see, I underestimated. So I'm going to go ahead and just get some more and put it on here. No big deal. This does dry a little fast, but you do have time to work on it. So it's not like you have to rush. Okay, and let's see if I can get all that spread. You guys, you are going to look like pros, let me tell you. And if you start getting all these custom gifts from me, it's because I can't help myself. Why go to the store and buy something like this when you can make it yourself? Exactly the way you want it, the colors you want it, the designs you want. They have seasonal. Now, Chalk Couture does retire some of their transfers, so they may have some for a while and then they decide to retire them. So I think I need my smaller one for those. I'm just going to try to spread it a little bit. Okay, and put a little bit more here and here. And let's see if I have my smaller transfer out. I think I do. My smaller squeegee. All right. So I got this one. It's a little easier on smaller areas, and then they sell larger squeegees for if you're doing larger surfaces, which I can't wait to do bigger ones. The transfers come in all different sizes. So I forgot the exact measurements, but they have smaller ones and medium sized ones and then larger ones. And of course, you can blend transfers because they cut up like this. So you can actually take transfers off of different sheets and kind of make a big custom made design. That's what I really like. You can do make it yours however you see fit. Can you guys hear me okay? I think you said it was better. Hopefully you can hear everything I'm saying. Okay. So basically that's it. I'm gonna go ahead and start with this one on the bottom because I put it on first and it's overlapping the top one. So I'm gonna get the corners and then I'm just gonna peel it across. Now when I'm done with this, as soon as I get off with you guys, I'm gonna go wash this in warm water. You can wash the paint off, you can put it right in warm water and then put it right back on the sheet that I peeled it off of for storage. And some people use like Clorox wipes or wipes to just clean them off. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and peel this one. And they're really sticky, especially the first time, but you'll see. Here it is. And I'm gonna go ahead and set this one down over here till I wash it. Okay. And then I'm just gonna wipe the board where there's anything on here. And look at this. Let me put me back in the video because I know you guys love to see me. Hi. Okay, so let's adjust a little bit. Look at that. Like, it just took a few minutes to make this a beautiful piece. All right. So, what do you guys think? Fun? Now, the cool thing is this will stay on here as long as it doesn't get wet, but if you want to wash this off and make a new stencil, like a new design for like another time, if you get tired of this and you want something different, you go ahead and wash it off with water. It's very simple. And you have to wait for it to dry first. I mean, I'm not going to, I would wipe it off for you right now, but I want it to dry first. It'll be dry in a minute. And if you're overlayering like different transfers, what you'll want to do, if this one layered over that one, I would want to make sure this is dry first before I go ahead and put another one on because it will peel it off. So you can use something as simple as a hair dryer or a little hand dryer like this if you just want to keep moving along rather quickly. It does dry pretty fast, but you just want to make sure it's completely dry if you're going to put another transfer on there and do another design and overlap a little bit. So anyway, that is it. This is super fun, and I hope that you will join me for another one soon. I'm gonna keep doing these live because they're so much fun, and I also wanna show you the different designs that I have and the different stencils that are available for this, and then start using some different colors. We can start doing some ombre, and then also, start adding like three-dimensional designs to it, right? We can hang this on here. This little wreath is from in front, in the bins in front of Target. Very inexpensive, makes a cute little spring piece or a little girly piece. And then today I found these leftover things that I had from like old parties. They're little mini chalkboards. You could put cute little designs on here or make them little nameplates for a dinner party or any kind of party. I thought that would be really fun. So like think about any of the chalkboard products. I found these two that I had. I don't know why I got them. I love parties, so I always buy the cute little party stuff. So That's it. If you have any questions, hi Lisa. If you have any questions, go ahead and put them in the comments. And then I'm also going to put a link in the comments where you can go check out my store and see what products you might like. If you live local and you want to come by and do this, feel free. I'd love to do this with you. It's so much fun. We can have a drink and we can do some crafting together. I really wanted to make the name of my page Arts and Crafts, but I'm just going to kind of use that as my tagline. So you do want to get your paint, which I'm kind of forgetting about, but go ahead and when you're done, just seal this up as soon as you can, because you don't want it to dry out. And if you have leftovers on your squeegee, just go ahead and put it back in there. See? So, fun! Thank you for joining me today. We'll be doing another one soon. And I'll see you guys later. Have a great Sunday. Enjoy the day. I'll talk to you later. Bye.